LaTeX is a common markup syntax used in scientific publishing. LaTeX enables document preparation for ETDRs, article publishing, and other uses. LaTeX is based on some tagging conventions. It is the tool of choice to create documents with mathematical notations, equations, and other such expressions. At Case State on the ETDR site, there is a LaTeX template that may be downloaded as a zipped folder. So just navigate to this to the templates and go ahead and click on this link, and the 2021 LaTeX source.zip folder has now been downloaded. Okay, so the contents may be opened in a LaTeX editor that has been installed on the local machine, or one option may be to go with overleaf.com for their free basic version. Please read the fine print to make sure that the terms are agreeable, because these may change. So basically, to upload the folder, you go to New Project to the left, and you want to upload the project. So we're going to say upload. It says select a zip file. So we're going to click on this and go to the Downloads folder. Click on LaTeX source and click open. And this is now being uploaded into the cloud. And it is now loading the template. So this is the general workspace for LaTeX on Overleaf. You will see you have a figures folder here to the left, which I will expand. The images here are PNG files, .png files. In general, PNG and .tiff are preferred formats because they are non-lossy compression methods. They are larger than JPEGs, but they retain a lot more of the original visual information. You will also see that you have a lot of different files with the .tech file extension. And you will see that some of these point to contents that may or may not be directly relevant to your ETDR, but like nomenclature, which only some ETDRs might use, and so on. You'll notice that the LaTeX template is for all theses, dissertations, and reports. You choose what parts of the template to include based on the requirements of your form. Now we're going to look at this panel with the basic source code. You'll see these percentage signs. Whenever these are present, this is commented out text. So this is just notations for you to read about how to use the basic template. So all of these are not code. They are inert. They're just information. This early section is, so this tells you again all the different elements you may or may not add in if you wish. And then we see some actual code here, right? So this preamble is the early section for the LaTeX template. The document class defines what sort of file it is. Here in the preamble, we have various packages that are loaded into the file, right? And you generally can add more if you want, but you don't want to add less. This will allow you to put in different graphics. It'll allow you to put in different types of math symbols and so forth, right? So you don't want to willy-nilly delete anything. You don't want to take out any of the styles. But when you come to particular sections, here it says input title.tech. And so the title.tech, this is the title.tech file with some of the basic coding. Here it says enter the title of your ETDR below. And so it says if you want it in large font, and then here's your title in sentence case, right? So not in title case, but in descending sentence case. So you'll be editing mostly, this is your main file, the ETDR template.tech. These others are supporting files that you can call from your main file. And so what you're going to do is you're going to put in your source code, save your file, and then when you're ready, or every so often, you can click this recompile. What this does is it will, this editor will read your code here to the left. It'll read your support files, read your images, and so on. And it will output your ETDR, right? So it'll have these different sections. It'll have your basic information. You need to be careful to not break any of the formatting. Like if you left off this little period on the end here, that is grounds for rejection, right? And then you'll just have to redo it until the graduate school is happy. There's a built-in table of contents. The links here to the right are navigable. So when you left click on them, you will jump right to that source, right? You can put in tables, you can put in figures, and so forth. Where the caption goes, how it's captioned, is determined in part by your research source citation method that is used in your field. And so you need to make sure to review that as well. And once everything looks good on this side, you would just come up here and download PDF, and then the PDF format is what you will be submitting to KREX at K-State, the K-State Research Exchange. And if yours is a doctoral dissertation, it will also, the PDF will also ultimately go to ProQuest. So as you can tell, you're not going to be submitting your whole LaTeX file or your source to the graduate school for consideration. Rather, it's the PDF that you will send. Now, if there is a mistake in your code as you're compiling or in recompiling, it'll trigger an error alert and it will tell you what the error is, and those can be fixed. Now, there are lots of nuances to this. When you create a table, there's special code that you have to put in to make that work. Some people go into Excel for that. Others use a transcoder online to go from an Excel table to LaTeX format, but apparently that's a bit messy. But give yourself a lot of time to get this put together right. So that you are able to format everything in the way that you need. Let's see. Right. Yeah, so that's basically it for this. There's a lot of nuance to all of this. Many students normally use LaTeX for their papers. In their different degree programs. So learning this won't be that difficult, and you'll get acclimated to it.